Hello everybody, today I am here to show you what I got in my November BoxyCharm. I'm really excited to open this up. I just got it in the mail yesterday, which I'm filming this on Saturday and I upload on Wednesdays. But I just got this yesterday, so I'm excited to open up. I didn't think I was going to get it till Monday, but it came a little early. And what else? Oh, the box is smaller. I didn't actually like measure it like height-wise, but I held it up next to the last month's box and it's smaller. So it's bulging with stuff in it, but hopefully it's still got a lot of good stuff in it. So I got my scissors. I'm gonna go ahead and open this up and let's see what we got. They came out apparently with a limited edition box and I waited a little too long to order it and it was all gone. So I'm not getting that, but I've still got my normally monthly box, so I'm sure it'll be fine. This is the little card that you get and it says sweater weather on it, which is cute. I'm all in for like being cozy right now because it's getting cold around here. When you open it up, you've got your products right there. You get this nice little crepe foam packing stuff on there. I'm sorry if it's really dark. I'm like looking at the lighting and the sun has already like went behind the trees, so this is not like my normal filming setup. I hate when the time changes and like things just get changed around a little bit, so I hope it's not too bad. The first thing that I'm noticing is this CoverFX. Well, can you even see it? It's so bright. CoverFX Illuminating Setting Spray. This looks really nice. Let's see. It retails for $31. It says it's a quick drying setting spray that sets makeup for all day wear and imparts instant all over illumination. It's alcohol free, so it's not drying to the skin, perfect for all skin tones and types. This actually doesn't sound too bad. The I've been using the Urban Decay, the D-Slick setting spray, and I think it was drying me out way too much, so I've stopped using that and I've got a different one that I'm trying that I like. So hopefully I'll talk about that in a monthly favorites. But this sounds nice. This sounds like something I can use in the winter because my skin gets super dry and I could get away with like illuminating foundation kind of stuff. Yeah, this looks really nice. The bottle is like iridescent, which is super pretty. The box was, it's a little iridescent as well, but the bottle's really iridescent, which is really pretty. Yeah, I'm excited to use this. Okay, so just opened it up. I don't really want to spray it on my face right now. But oh, holy cow, it is like, you're not gonna be able to see it, but it is like a light pink illuminating highlighting kind of color. Oh boy, can't wait. Oh, you know what, I'm gonna put a little bit on like my hand and see what it looks like on my hand. Oh yeah, it is super sparkly. Well, I say that, but not like in a bad way for a setting spray, but I bet it's just going to add just like the perfect sheen. I can barely even see the sparkle right now. I just blended it out, just a little drop of it on my hand. It smells nice. It almost smells like lotion-y. It's drying really nice. So I can see myself getting along with this really well. And my hands are super dry. Let's not look at them too much. Oh my gosh. You guys are going to give me such a hard time. My knuckles are terrible. Where I did put it on is it looks moisturized. Not that I would put this all over my skin, but looks promising. Let's see what we've got here. Something by Luxie, which it has the BoxyCharm symbol on it, so it must be a BoxyCharm exclusive. I just did a big no-no and I changed the lighting in the middle of a video. I'm sure that I'll hate that later. But it was just so dark. Hopefully this is a little bit better. I think it looks okay. Okay, so this is something by Luxie, which I think I've had brushes by them before, not necessarily in this box. Yeah, I have a tapered blending brush by Luxie, and I love that brush, so I'm excited to check this out. This is a quad eye travel set. I don't know, are they brushes? They're brushes. Oh yes. And it looks like this is like a BoxyCharm exclusive since it says BoxyCharm on it. Oh, they're so cute. Okay, what brushes are in here? Okay, the box doesn't say, but this retails for $32. It's a quad eye travel set. I think I already said that. So it says, take your eye game on the go with this quad travel set created with handcrafted synthetic brushes. Brushes, right? Yeah. This is really nice. Oh, they probably say what they are on them. Oh my gosh. Okay, nowhere does it say, like, they don't have names. They just have numbers. So this one is 213T. This one is 207T. This one is 221T, and this is 227T. This one looks like just a nice kind of all-over brush. Maybe it's a little bit fluffier. Ooh, no, you know what? This one seems a little bit more all-over. This one seems more of like a crease brush. If you were traveling, I can see how these things would work. And then this one is just maybe more of like a smudger kind of thing. And then this one is fluffy, but it's angled, which is really nice, so that might be good for the crease as well. I'm happy with these. Granted, they're travel size. I don't travel very often, but I feel like that would be something really nice to keep in your purse. But I feel like even just at my desk, at my vanity over here, I'll probably use these. They're a little on the short end, so you're kind of holding them like right at the end there, because I don't like to be too close to the bristles, but I could use these. I don't know how much use I'll get out of them, but I think they'll probably be really nice to have. This, I am not sure what this is. Let me take a look. I think the brand, oh, it's Laga. It almost looked like a U. Oh no, it's a Q. Oh my gosh, I'm so confused. I don't know how to pronounce this. It's L-A-Q-A. Laka? And company, Cloud Lips. This retails for $17. An airy matte lipstick that provides full coverage but feels as light as a cloud. This highly pigmented lipstick has a matte finish for long-lasting, fluffy, pouty lips that stay put. So let's see if we have a color. I don't see any indication of a color, like a name for it. Holy moly. Not my color. Not my color at all. I don't even know if I'm going to swatch this because I don't even know if I want to keep it. That is a super dark, berry wine kind of color. It almost doesn't even look... Oh, now I can't get it back up. It almost doesn't even look very red. It almost looks brown. I'm not sure how I feel about that. I'm not going to swatch it because, like I said, I don't know if I'm going to keep it, but at the same time, I don't know who I'm going to give it to that would wear it. Not thrilled with that one. Okay, the next thing I'm pulling out are in these little foil packets. Let's see what this is. KNC Beauty All Natural Collagen Infused Lip Mask. So that's interesting. Retails for $15. I'm not sure if they mean $15 a piece. There's three of them in here, or if like a three pack is $15. I'm not really sure. It says they are an innovative jelly mask for your lips that hydrate, moisturize, and plump your pout with natural ingredients. So that's really nice. My lips get super dry, so this could be really nice to use, the moisturize and hydrate part and condition. I know I don't really have big lips, but I don't really go for like plumping stuff. But these might be nice to use. It says apply to clean lips for 15 to 20 minutes. It says to use them 2 to 3 times a week. So I guess they give you three so that you have enough to use it for like a whole week. And then you can actually have like a pretty good opinion on it instead of just using it once. Okay. Oh, we've got an eyeshadow palette. Oh, I love eyeshadow palettes. This is something by Winky Luxe, which I feel like sounds familiar, but I don't know if I've ever heard of it. Let's see, where is it at? Winky Luxe Kitten Palette. It retails for $25. These ultra soft shadows glide on like a dream. The universally flattering collection of shades makes this palette as lovable as a kitten. It features highly pigmented shadows in 4 finishes: holographic, matte, satin, and glitter. Okay, this is promising. Now the colors are on the back. So let's see. Oh, by the way, the packaging is super cute. It has kittens all over it. It's so cute. Oh my gosh. Okay, let's see if this is any good. So it's just in like a cardboard packaging. The colors have like transferred a little bit on the top. No mirror. which I don't need a mirror. I very rarely use that. I really would like if I could fold all the way back, but I can't. But these are the colors. I like these. I definitely like these a lot. On the back, it gives you all of the names. So this one they call holographic, like on the back. And it does look very holographic. It looks two-toned, very pretty. These are really nice. You've got a matte tan, what would you call that? Like a tan shade. You've got a matte, almost an off-white, a matte plum color, a matte brown. It almost looks like the matte brown has been like touched. Not with like a finger, but I don't know, it's not super clean. Got this gorgeous gold color, which I always appreciate a really pretty gold color. This one is really pretty. It's a cool blue type of color. I just touched one of them. And then that holographic one, it's like blue and like pink. Oh, and this one's pink too. That one's satin, I would say. And then you have a really pretty red color up here at the top. Well, at the bottom. I've been holding it upside down. This is nice. I don't feel like I'm super... It is magnetic. I don't feel like I'm super impressed with this. This is probably the one thing I'm the most excited for, which is the Cover FX spray. I think I'm gonna really get along with this really well this time of the year. When it comes to everything else, like this lip, that was a dark color. I almost wonder if I could use it as a eyeshadow or something. I don't know. I'm gonna swatch it for you guys. I changed my mind. I'm gonna swatch it because I really don't know anybody that I can give this to. Oh, it's really red. Now I'm kind of glad I swatched it. It's not brown at all. It's like red, red though. I'm trying not to show you my really dry knuckles right now. But that is a super wine berry color. More wearable, not my favorite color. Not the color that I gravitate towards, which is actually kind of nice because I don't buy this kind of stuff in the store, so to get given it isn't too bad. So that's not too bad. Maybe I'll like that. It went on really creamy too, which was nice. I don't know how much putting it to the test I can do on the back of my hands since my hands are dry. Let's see. The lip masks, those are going to be nice. I think I will like these, especially if they do actually hydrate my lips because, like I said, my hands get dry, my lips get dry this time of the year. These, I really like Luxie brushes, but at the same time, I don't really need travel size. I would appreciate just like one full-size Luxie brush, I think. And then that just leaves the palette, which maybe I should like swatch a little bit. I think I'm gonna just go for like one shade. Let's do the holographic shade. That seems to make the most sense to me. Ooh, that's really pretty. It's kind of powdery, but it's going on really nicely. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see it. I put it right here above the wine color. Right here. Sorry for that sniffle. I don't know what's wrong with me. I just like woke up sniffling this morning. I don't feel sick. But it's just a really pretty like pink champagne-y color, but then it has like blue and green like iridescence to it, which that's really pretty. I think it's gonna be like a subtle eyeshadow, a subtle eyeshadow, but it's still gonna be really pretty. So maybe these are gonna be a little bit better than what I thought. I'm not impressed with like the packaging and everything, but I mean, I like the print on the front, but it's just a little, it's dirty a little bit, and I think that's why I don't like it. It's just a little dirty. They probably shouldn't have went with the light pink on the inside. Like, that's probably why. But all in all, I mean, I don't hate this box. I'm sure I got my money's worth, and I can't wait to get next month's. Like I said, I didn't get the limited edition box. If they come back out with it, like, more available, I would totally pick it up. It had some really good brands in it. They didn't show you what was in it, but they showed you the different brands that they were going to feature in the box, and I didn't get it. I like saw it, and then I was like getting ready to order it, and I'm like, whoa, wait a minute, back up. Why don't you think about this for like 2 minutes? So I thought about it, and then by the time I went back to order it, it was gone. Oh well. Anyways. This was my November box. I think I'm probably the most excited for this because this is perfect for me for this time of the year. I will definitely get plenty. plenty of use out of that. I'll leave everything listed that I got in my box in the description box down below. I'll also leave you a link to BoxyCharm in case you want to sign up. And yeah, I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. You can also hit the subscribe button. That means a lot to me. You can also follow me on Instagram at Hair by Lizzie Bug. I hope you guys are having a wonderful week. And until next time, bye. I have got hair all over me. Between my hair and then Daisy's hair. My husband really wants Pizza Hut pizza and I really just want the cheese sticks. I'm like, just give me an order of cheese sticks, I'll be good.
Kitty cat is so cute.